In this segment on cell membrane transport, we're now going to be focusing on the various types of membrane transport. Now, specifically in this video, we'll be focusing on simple diffusion. And so when we look at this outline of membrane transport, we're going to be focusing on movement of solutes that is along a gradient. So these are all types of passive transport. And there are three types. So the first type we're going to be discussing is simple diffusion. You'll have a separate video lecture for facilitated diffusion, osmosis, primary active transport, and secondary active transport. So before we even begin with this section, what I would like for you to do is to look at the various transport properties that are listed on this slide. For example, spontaneous, not spontaneous, may or may not require a transmembrane protein. And what I want you to do for each of these properties is to decide, is that a property of passive transport or is that a property of active transport? And so please pause the video and then decide which of these properties belong to what type of transport. And so let's go ahead and go through these. Okay, so I'm hoping that you've already paused the video and now you're ready to check your answers. And so remember, if we're dealing with some sort of passive movement, here's a hill, I have a rock sitting up on top of a hill, okay? If it's an active process, here's my hill and I have a rock sitting down at the bottom of the hill. So a spontaneous property means that it's just gonna happen, right? So for example, this rock is just gonna come down that hill on its own, okay? So spontaneous is a form of passive transport. Now, not spontaneous, it's not spontaneous for this rock to automatically go up the hill all on its own, right? It would need some help. So that's an active process. It's not spontaneous. Now, may or may not require a transmembrane protein. That's going to be for passive types of transport that we'll discuss in a lot of detail here shortly. And then requires a transmembrane protein, that's an active form, okay? Now, requiring energy. Would it require energy to push that rock up that hill? And the answer is yes. So active forms will require energy. Passive forms, on the other hand, don't require any energy. It doesn't take energy for the rock to go down the hill, does it? So passive forms do not require energy. So then we have a solute moving along a gradient. So when we talk about a solute moving along a gradient, then that means this rock is going from a high concentration toward a low concentration. So along a gradient means high concentration toward a low concentration. Okay, and that's considered a passive process. Solutes that move against a gradient means that they're going from a low concentration toward a higher concentration. And that's an active process. Okay, so now with those properties in mind, let's go ahead and we're first going to be discussing simple diffusion. So remember, simple diffusion falls underneath of a passive type of transport, which automatically tells you your solute moves along a gradient, and it automatically tells you that it does not require any energy. All right, so here we have a phospholipid bilayer, right, that's making up the plasma membrane. And we want to first off talk about solutes that can passively diffuse through a membrane. So if it's simple diffusion, whatever solute I may have, we'll just put X over here. This is my solute. This solute can freely diffuse through the membrane. That's another way of saying that it has a high permeability. Okay, it freely diffuses, a high permeability. And so if you remember the structure of the phospholipid bilayer and the chemical makeup of the bilayer, it'll help you understand why the solutes can freely diffuse. So remember that these tails here are fatty acids, FA, fatty acids. So these fatty acid tails are fat. They're fats. So anything that's fat soluble will freely diffuse through that membrane. So if it's fat soluble, a couple of terms for you to remember, that means it's lipophilic. Phil or philic means to love. Lipo, fat. Okay, so fat soluble substances are lipophilic. So if they love fat, they are going to be afraid of water. So they're going to be hydrophilic. phobic. So hydro is water, phobic, fear. So they fear water. Okay. Now keep in mind that water, if I draw out one water molecule for you, water molecules have partial charges. The hydrogens have positives, the oxygen has a negative. And so any molecule that's nonpolar means it has no partial charges. So if there's no partial charges, it is not attracted to water. So it's afraid of water. Okay, we should maybe put a big red X there. It's afraid of water. So it's hydrophobic. Okay, so what this is telling us then is that we have substances that can freely diffuse, include lipophilic substances, right? We've mentioned that already. Hydrophobic solutes, all right? Nonpolar solutes. And then we have this question of, well, small and polar or large and polar? So the answer to this is that small polar molecules can actually freely diffuse the membrane, even though they have partial charges, and that's just because of their size. They're really small. So we have small polar molecules. An example of a small and polar molecule would be water that could freely diffuse. Now, here's the catch. This is a really important point for you to remember. In this course, if we are talking about water movement, meaning the diffusion of water, it is only going to be moving if there is an aquaporin present, and therefore we're only talking about diffusion of water with osmosis. That will make working your molecular transport problems a lot simpler for you. So again, if we talk about diffusion of water, we are talking about osmosis. That is not simple diffusion. Okay, different concept. All right, so that takes care of the solutes that can freely diffuse. And then since it's simple diffusion, we know it's a type of passive transport. So that tells us that our solute is going to be moving along a gradient, okay, which is the same thing as saying down the gradient, which is the same thing as saying from a high concentration toward a low concentration. So let's practice. So pause the video and then answer this question. The solute is the green dot. It's a lipid-soluble molecule. Okay, so I'm assuming you've already paused the video, and we want to know in which direction will the solute diffuse. So this is a lipid-soluble molecule, meaning it's lipophilic, right, and hydrophobic. So we know it can freely diffuse. Okay, so when we look at the concentration, we know that there's a high concentration of the solute inside the cell. There's a low concentration outside of the cell. So wherever you have a higher concentration, there'll be a greater frequency of collisions, right, amongst those solutes. The more collisions you have, the more energy that gets created, and hence you're going to drive those solutes across the membrane. Okay, so this solute is going to be moving out of the cell, which is the same thing as saying it's moving into the extracellular fluid. So the correct answer for this is option D,